released four albums with those cats, and actually, yeah, five, cause on the fourth one, that's what they got the deal, and we asked for what we want, and they was like, "Nah, we can't give y'all that kind of money." Woo de woo. Our contract was getting ready to be up. We wanted our own label. It wasn't no beef or none of that going. We just felt like we didn't thought we didn't think we knew everything, but we thought we knew enough to start our own shit. And that was the big pitch. That's what we wanted. You know what I'm saying? We wanted our own shit. And they was like, "Nah, we can't do that, dog." You know, so contracts went this way and that way. Y'all got killed. So we got off the label. A year later, they put out another album on us, a Greatest Hits album. You know, so all together, it was like five albums that we had with Cash Money.
Okay, yeah, let's go back for a second. So after y'all fourth album, you said, y'all, they actually went. Everything before that was basically independent.
Right.
Okay,
right.
so after the fourth album, they go to Universal.
Universal, right.
Okay, which they're still, which is crazy. Baby is like one of the few who was able to eke that deal with owning the masters
Right.
and things of that nature.
Ray Charles type shit.
Yeah, like people don't understand how big that is. Like
right. And
for Baby and Cash Money to be able to eke that type of deal where
right.
they really running the show. You know what I'm saying? For the most
Dead.
part.
Right.
So when they inked this deal, this was basically y'all was the hottest people on that on the record label.
Basically, they got the deal off our numbers.
Yeah.
They
Okay, that's
shot
what
the deal on our numbers.
Okay, that's what I wanted to get into.
Yeah,
So like
and
y'all was because of the work y'all, you know, it was a collective. They did their thing, y'all
right,
did y'all
right,
thing.
Right, right.
And y'all name was the thing that said, okay, well, they moving these units at Universal. We feel comfortable
Exactly.
cutting them this type of check because they moved this in the streets without us.
Exactly.
Off of you. Okay.
Yeah. I mean,
So.
you had the BG on the label. BG was doing numbers. Lil Slim was doing numbers. Miss T was doing numbers. Kilo G, Pimp Daddy. Everybody was doing numbers, but nobody wasn't even coming close to ourselves, man.
So, you know, with that going, do you remember what year this was?
It was 96.
So this is about 3 years after y'all first album.
Right.
About 3 years after y'all first album,
Yeah.
they go into to Universal.
Yep.
And get the deal, but y'all are like, y'all want to do y'all own thing.
Right.
Okay. So y'all see them, that it ain't no beef, it ain't none of that
I didn't
going
want none
on,
of that. It
but
was
y'all
like.
go do y'all own thing. So do y'all go ink a deal or?
Now, what happened was Yella was murdered.
Okay.
In the midst of all this shit happening,
Yeah.
Yella was murdered.
Yeah.
Tech went to jail.
Okay.
So
Now,
that put.
let's back up a little bit. Okay, so y'all hit song, y'all most popular song is already out at this
Right,
time.
right.
Which album was that on?
Uptown
What
for
number?
Life,
What number?
number four.
Everybody know the album name. That was album number four.
Right.
And that was the album. That y'all, after the album, y'all left Cash Money. Y'all leave
Yeah.
Cash Money, and what happens in y'all career after that?
Well, we kept getting in trouble. I mean, we really went on our haters because if Tech wasn't in trouble, I was in trouble. If I wasn't in trouble, Tech was in trouble. We couldn't really get it right. You know what I'm saying? So it took us, when he went to jail, for me to land and handle my business and create a solo album. I had a solo album called Another Bitch that was released in 99. And I've actually done half of my album in San Antonio, you know, by a guy named Gregory D. I know y'all familiar with Gregory D. He's one of forefathers of pioneers of New Orleans.
Okay.
Well, he was like, "Yeah, man, I got this hookup out in San Antonio. All you gotta do is take that ride and stay out there for a minute." So I went, done 3 months out there, came back with a solid little album, you know what I'm saying? So I set us up. I went to getting our name back flying, you know, after everybody said, "What happened to UNLV?" They ain't saying that shit no more. They was like, "Girl, UNLV got a new album," this and all that kind of shit. So Tech came home in 2001, and we released Return of UNLV, the Trendsetters, which was a damn good album. We sold a lot of units. We started our record label with my uncle. Uncle Hardy came back in the picture and his partner named Pinky. So once we released that, I don't know, you probably too young to remember Southwest. It was a distributor out here.
Oh yeah, we know about them.
Man,
yeah, everybody was on them.
Yeah, dog.
Everybody went through Southwest.
Everybody.
It was two major ones out here, huh?
It was Southwest, they had Omni too.
Okay, that's what I say. It was two major distributors out here that everybody went
to. Yeah, but Southwest, I mean, we ate like a motherfucker from them, dog. I'm talking about we were picking up $100,000, $200,000, $300,000checks like it was candy, dog.
Dang, that's crazy.
You know what I'm saying? But they went out of business and that fucked us up right there. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? So we were like, damn, let's rethink this. We gotta get some more distribution. We wasn't ready to go fuck with the majors because we was eating. You know, and we felt like we learned from baby them, dog. Believe that. You know, we learned from them niggas, man. You eat, you straight, and nothing you want for, continue to eat, man. You ain't gotta go, you know, when you get enough leverage, then you could get deals like they got. You know what I'm saying? And they only got that kind of leverage because of what they did. So we learned that method. And we was deaf, you know what I'm saying? Southwest closed, so we just went with another distributor. I think it was Solo Selecto Hits. We went with Selecto Hits and another one in New Orleans called Gonzalez. And, you know, we ate from them, man. It's just been putting out albums. You know, we had problems with record labels because every time we really tried to do something, we always had a partner with us instead of just me and Tech doing it. You know what I'm saying? I mean, business is business. I ain't cry about it, but it was all good through it all.
Gotcha.
You know what I mean?
Gotcha. So, when y'all was... So would you say like kind of this y'all getting in a lot of trouble and then just the game kind of changing a little bit?
Yeah.
Like kind of, you know.
Yeah, all that came in play too.
Came into play too.
As we fucking around slipping and getting in trouble and shit, the game is slowly changing on us, you know.